And then with a little bit of technique you that I'm learning now.
Ballroom is this. And then technique and your craft.
Yeah, born with it, and
you
then the technique.
Teach the knockout.
You can't teach it. Either you have it or you don't.
You're from New Jersey originally?
Originally from New Jersey.
Have you been to New Jersey?
Yes.
How do you like it? Is it like the Ukraine?
It's like, yeah, four seasons.
Fucking cold.
Have you been in the Ukraine?
No, I've never been in Ukraine.
How would he do in the Ukraine if he went there? Would he take over?
No, just have a cold. And this
cold.
Time.
I hate cold. That's
minus
why I'm
20.
Yeah, see, I can't do that. That's why I'm in Southern California. Where we at? What's this? Burbank.
That's why you live there.
Yeah.
It's beautiful out here.
Yeah, that's why I'm on the east. That's why I'm on the West Coast.
Last time, the funniest story you told me when you went to Kmart to buy hand wraps, people were harassing you.
The one guy asked me about was it Kmart? Where was that?
Walmart.
Walmart asked me why am I at Walmart if I'm driving a Bentley?
What does that have to do with anything? People are funny. Have you had a chance to meet Shane Mosley Jr.?
Yeah.
What do you think about him?
I like Shane. He's focused. And he has a lot of pressure on him being the son of a former future Hall of Famer. And he's determined. Like he accepts all the challenges, the criticism, and he wants it all. He goes out there and he performs and he works hard. He works harder than the average amateur fighter you're gonna see. With him, you would think, he would just get by, I'm Shane Mosley's son, I can do this, I can do that, but nah, he wants to get in there as far as the best. Then he'll win a round, to see if he can get more rounds.
You hear what he's saying?
Then he'll jump on the bag.
He said that you would expect you to take it easy, you're Shane Mosley's son. He said you work harder than any other amateur out there.
I appreciate it, Kendall.
And then he sits around, does 6-7 rounds sparring, waited round, alright, let me see if I can get some more sparring. Me? I done did my rounds, I'd have been in the Bentley on my way downtown Los Angeles or something. But he's still waiting around to spar more, jumps on the bag, does a lot of work that your average amateur is not gonna put in.
You know what? It's how much work you put in is what you'll get back. There's no shortcuts.
There's no shortcuts. And, being he's Shane Mosley's son, he has a lot of pressure on him. So he's working hard to meet those expectations. And, I take my hat off to him. I wouldn't want to be in his shoes at all.
You remember I saw you fight at, was it Maywood in that tournament?
Maywood.
He looks like a different fighter today. I just told him that.
Yeah.
Different fighter. And it's all what, 2 years ago? Three?
About 2 years ago.
And plus, now you're
Because he wants it. It's the attitude that fighters have. A lot of fighters get in, they think they're working hard, and they're just basically just going through the motions in their mind, and they're just going, in their mind they say they want it, but physically they're just going through the motion. He actually does what he says. He wants it, and he proves that he wants it. Can't beat that.
Have you sparred Kendall yet?
No, I've never sparred Kendall.
He also has power.
Yeah.
See, that's what I'm most known for is the power. Because
what do you want to be known for?
Knockouts. I don't care what I'm known for. I just wanted to be known. Once upon a time, I just wanted people to know my name. Now they know it, and I have no quarrels about that.
Okay, you against Lucas Matisse. What can we expect if that happens?
You know what? You can expect that fight to end in a knockout because he's a power puncher. I'm a power puncher. What else would the fans or anybody else expect? You expect somebody to go to sleep.
But Kendall, you're not afraid of fighting anybody, anywhere, anytime. Some fighters are a little more picky. Why?
You know what? That's just their personality. Me, I came up hard the hard way. I had a militant type father that, if you got suspended, most kids get in trouble for fighting in school. I get in trouble if I didn't win the fucking fight. If I won the fight, next time we get out of school or something like that. But I won the fight, so I'm good.
It's okay if you get in fights in school as long as you win.
As long as you win. Or you didn't quit, or you didn't bitch up and try to go the other way, whatever. You met that challenge, you took it on. Alright.
Nobody ever bullied Kendall Holt, ever.
You know what? That's not true.
Really?
I was first grade. This kid picked on me every, sat behind me and picked on me every day. I bust his nose in school every day, got suspended, and he would still mess with me. I would chase this kid home every day from school, and he would still fuck with me.
And what ended up happening?
I don't remember, but as a matter of fact, I ended up changing schools or my mother moved or something like that. But no matter what, this kid just, every day.
That's common.